California's children are filled with promise and imagination and endless possibilities.
What I want to be when I grow up is a doctor.
I want to be a professional cheerleader.
You may not be a big person, but you have a big imagination. Now it's time to use it to think about how you can keep yourself and your family safe during an emergency.
If I had a power, it would be to escape from a place that's on fire.
The superpower that I would have is teleportation. I would be able to grab my friends and family and take them to a safe place.
Maybe like super strength?
Telekinesis. So then I can move stuff that are heavy.
The power to see the future, so I can like help them and tell them what to do and what to not do.
You don't have to be a first responder, a grown-up, or even a superhero in order to make a difference.
You can be brave by helping your family.
Preparing for emergencies is another important way to keep your family safe. And you can help lead the way.
I would tell my mom, come on, mommy, it's time to get out the house.
And I would help my family by making sure the bags are packed.
Grown-ups could bring extra food and water to keep them hydrated.
Help them pack the bags, help them carry stuff into the car.
Have a bag ready in case of an emergency and get your family out of the house in time.
I will put in my go bag, a medic kit, a blanket, clothing, and snacks or food.
Probably my phone, my charger for my phone if I find the nearest outlet.
I'll bring my PlayStation. Get some snacks.
I would put my stuffed animals because I had them since I was young and I love them very much.
Kids are not powerless when it comes to disaster preparedness.
I could tell kids to be ready, making a plan.
Be brave by helping others and standing up for themselves. I've been there before.
Just make sure your family's safe and make sure you're safe.
To save people is good.
My name is Rhiannon, and I am 9 years old.
My name is Brody, and I'm 7 years old.
My name is Daniel Reyes. I am 12 years old.
My name is KR, and these are the things you need to be ready.
These are the things that you can do to be ready.
Here are the 5 steps of being prepared.
Number 1, get alerts.
Number 2, make a plan.
Step 3, pack a go bag.
Number 4, build a stay box.
Step 5, help your friends and neighbors get ready.
With at least those 5 steps of emergency preparedness, every kid has the superpower to know what you and your family should do to be ready.
If you and your family make a plan.
If you and your family make a plan.
If you and your family make a plan.
If you and your family make a plan, everything will be okay.
We'll be okay.
Special thanks to the La Familia Counseling Center and the Child Abuse Prevention Center.